Have courage to express your thoughts. The new literature teacher reads a poem to the students. Then he asks them for an opinion, but everyone is silent. There is no wrong answer, he encourages them, but nobody says anything. The teacher takes the students to the park and tells them to lie down in the grass. He does it too. They watch the clouds in the sky. The teacher asks them, what are the clouds like? Do you see a special figure in the sky? Everyone is silent. The teacher continues, look, the cloud there looks like a dog's head. The students laugh. The other cloud is like a dragon, says Victor. There's a leg that wants to hit the ball, Noemi says. Very good, the teacher praises them. All get the courage and tell what they see in the sky. The teacher is happy that the students now have the courage to express their thoughts. Have courage to express your thoughts. The new literature teacher read a poem to the students. Then he asked them what had occurred to them while listening, but nobody wanted to say anything. You are allowed to say everything that went through your mind. There is no wrong answer, the teacher encouraged them. The teacher took the students to the nearby park. Everyone laid down in the grass and looked at the sky. What shapes do you see in the sky when you look at the clouds? The teacher asked. Nobody wanted to answer. I'll start, said the teacher. Look, the cloud there looks like a dog's head. The two holes are his eyes and the hanging part is his tongue. The students laughed. The other cloud is like a dragon spitting fire, Victor shouted. There is the leg of a football player. He's trying to hit the ball right now, said Noemi. Very well. Tell everyone what you see, the teacher praised them. The students liked the game with the clouds very much, and soon they all told what they have discovered in the sky. The teacher was pleased that they have a rich imagination, but even more pleased that they have the courage to express their thoughts.